This is all new to me. And I originally had the idea to do the Nerf War. It was something that I just thought of myself on an afternoon, and I thought this would be a cool idea. So I called up one of my friends, and we decided that it would be a fun thing to do. So I brought him over, and basically the first thing we did was we threw together a quick trailer. But we knew that we couldn't really get anything going, and we couldn't actually start the production without, you know, actors of some sort or someone to back us up. So we had a very limited selection when it came to actors. We had friends, but they were not going to be around a lot. Mostly the main cast of characters was my neighbors and one of my friends. So even in one of the scenes we were going to film, and we decided we were going to film that day, but one of my friends, was one of my neighbors actually, had something else he needed to be doing. He may have been sick, I'm not sure. And we were kind of stuck, because there was nothing else we could do. So we had to kind of alter the plot to accommodate for this. We kind of killed him off, not killed him off, temporarily got rid of him by saying that he was shot in the shoulder. It'd be Sergeant Reiner. If you notice, he wasn't in one of the scenes, that was because he wasn't available that day. So we actually took advantage of Sergeant Reiner not being around to add a new character, Sergeant Reiner's replacement. We needed characters wherever we could get them. So essentially, you know, if someone was over, we'd say, hey, do you want to be on YouTube? You want to, you know, shoot a gun for us? And they'd be like, sure. So that's how we got our characters. Sessions were very difficult for us. We had not many characters, and whenever we made a shot, there was usually at least three or four mess-ups before we got one that we were actually ready to put in the video. One major thing that we had a problem with was dialogue. We would brainstorm things, and they would sound a lot better in our heads than they would actually sound on camera. So, in the final product, we scrapped almost all of the dialogue, and it's, for the most part, purely action. We added certain sequences in between to kind of fill people in on what was going on, but we tried dialogue, and it just was extremely stressful and not working for us. Hey guys, to complete awesome thing number 16, we've come to Treasure Island. It's an old naval base, and we're hoping that we can find a turret here. So we're kind of biking around, hoping we'll find something. We'll keep you posted. I think we found it, man.
ProStuffTV, and we found like a turret, so gotta see what's in here.
All Well, this is like terrifyingly high.
Ninjawaffles 14. Dude, we're in like an AA turret. In like World War II. This is like kinda cool. Like for reals. And then like over here is where you like look out an A. Like over here. Dude, that's like really cool. Like, it's like, dude, this is actually. And we're in like friggin'. Wow, we want Treasure Island. And we just found a place. And dude, like, seriously? I don't like, if it was raining and I was homeless, I'd love to be in this place.
Like a boss, dude.
And then over here, I don't know what's over here. I have no idea. But imagine, like, being in here and being shot at and, like, having this, like, blow up. Like, screwed. I'd, like, hate to be in here while, like, a war's going on and there's planes flying over me. So this got shot down and just blew up. Just, like, no way of survival.
The police roll by.
I want the cop and it's gonna like shut it all down.
USA!
Dude, look at those.